Good wishes, dear students. In today's class, we will learn about few more concepts involved in chemical kinetics chapter. To start with, let's take elementary reaction. Definition for elementary reaction is each and every single step in a reaction mechanism is called as an elementary reaction. So, an elementary step is characterized by its molecularity. So there are two terms you need to understand along with an example. I mean the concept you need to know. One, what's the meaning of elementary reaction? Meaning the elementary steps gives us elementary reaction. And the second one, molecularity. I have taken an example. Let me rewrite it to explain it to you. Consider a reactant A giving us the product D. So A is the reactant, D is the product. This is the overall reaction. But in reality, no reaction takes place immediately. As soon as you add the reactant, we don't get the product. There are so many other smaller reactions taking place within them. Let me make it clear. The same reaction, reactant A undergoes certain type of reaction to give us B. Further, B undergoes little more reaction to give us the C. Further, C undergoes little more reactions to give us the final product D. So, I hope I'm making my points clear. Reactant A giving us the product D is the overall reaction. But in reality, no reaction takes place when at the stretch. There are so many other smaller reactions taking place before giving the formation of a product. So, these individual steps are called as an elementary step. The reaction on the whole is called as an elementary reaction. So, if you look at the number of elementary steps involved in it, A to B is the first type of elementary reaction. B to C is the second type of elementary reaction. C to D is the third type of elementary reaction. So, how many elementary steps are there in this reaction? Three elementary steps are there. I hope I made your thorough with the concept. So that's the meaning of each and every single step in a reaction mechanism is called elementary reaction. I hope you understand the concept well. The second one, an elementary step is characterized by its molecularity. What's the meaning of elementary step? The step involved from converting A to B is say, elementary step one. B to C is elementary step 2. C to D is elementary step 3. So each step is characterized by its molecularity. So what's the definition for a molecularity? It is the total number of reactant species. Reactant species when we say that is atoms or it could be atoms or ions or molecules that are involved in an elementary step is called molecularity of that particular step. So, all you have to remember, earlier classes you have seen, the rate of the reaction depends on the concentration of the reactant alone, not on the product. And that's the reason to calculate the molecularity of a particular elementary step, we consider the total number of reactant species alone involved in the elementary step. From this explanation, you understand the meaning of elementary step. Let's understand how to calculate the molecularity in each step. Consider, I have taken the example of three types of reaction. The first reaction has got only one reactant. The second reaction has got two reactant. And the third reaction has got a three reactant. Since we are learning the concept of molecularity, I am not looking at the product side of it. Our point of interest is only on the reactant side, A plus B, A plus B plus C. So if you look here, I have written molecularity is 1 for this particular reaction. Why do I say molecularity is 1? Because total number of reactants taking part in this reaction is only 1. So 1 mole of A gives me 1 mole of B. Hence the molecularity is 1. In another term, we can call them to be a unimolecular reaction. Unimolecular reaction, when you hear a word, all you have to remember is the number of reactant is 1 there. Only 1 reactant is present. Let's move on to the second type of reaction. I have written molecularity is 2. Why do I say molecularity is 2? count how many number of reactants are there? 1 mole of reactant A and 1 mole of reactant B. So together they give me only 2 number, total number of reactant species are 2. So that is referred to as a molecularity. Since the number is 2, it's also called as a bimolecular reaction. So unimolecular reaction when you say reactant species is 1. Bimolecular when you say the reactant species is 2. Let's move on to the third type of category. How many moles of reactants are there? 1 mole of A, 1 mole of B and 1 mole of C. When we add the number, what's the answer? 3. Hence, the molecularity is 3 in this case. It's also called as a tertiary reaction or a trimolecular reaction. I hope the concept of what's the meaning of elementary reaction involving the elementary step and the term molecularity you are clear with. Let's take one more example. Rate determining step, you have the second concept. The first concept in today's class is elementary reaction followed by what's the meaning of elementary step followed by a molecularity. Now let's understand for a given quest reaction, how to calculate the molecularity term in it and how to understand the overall reaction along with the rate determining step. So the example as it is given in the textbook I have taken, but I simplified it in a smaller concept. So decomposition of hydrogen peroxide catalyzed by iodide. You know the work of catalyst. It helps us to increase the rate of the reaction or the increases the activation energy. We will see about this concept at the end of the chapter. So all you have to remember, as you have learnt it in the lower classes, the purpose of adding a catalyst is to increase the rate of the reaction. And finally, the catalyst comes out as it is. So consider a decomposition reaction. Decomposition when we see, it gets split into 2 moles of hydrogen peroxide in the aqueous medium. They undergo a reaction with the catalyst to give us the 2 moles of water molecule and 1 mole of oxygen. This is the, as I told you, overall reaction. Hydrogen peroxide giving us the water and oxygen. Overall reaction. As I told you, reaction does not take place in at one single stage. There are so many other elementary steps involved in it, meaning smaller reactions taking place. So A is converted into B, B into C and C into D, and it goes on depending on the type of reactions we are taking in. So these steps involved in it are called as an elementary step. So let's understand how many types of elementary steps are involved in converting a decomposition of hydrogen peroxide to water molecule and oxygen. So experimental steps involved in it are very easy, nothing complicated in it. In step 1, how many moles of hydrogen peroxides we have taken? 2 moles. So out of the 2, 1 mole of hydrogen peroxide reacts with a catalyst iodide. If you see here, H2O2 we've got. Hey, out of the H2O2, water molecule comes out as a H2O. Out of the 2 oxygen, 1 has come with a water molecule. How many more are left over? 1 oxygen. That combines with a iodide to give us a OI anion. So if we calculate for this particular step, what's the molecularity? I have written it to be 2. How do we get the molecularity to be 2? What is molecularity? Number of reactant species involved in the elementary step. So 1 mole of hydrogen peroxide reacts with 1 mole of iodide giving us the product. So molecularity is calculated only in terms of the reactant. Hence the number of reactant species are 2. Hence we are writing molecularity is 2. So this is a step 1. 1 mole of hydrogen peroxide reacts with the iodide giving us a water molecule and OI minus anion. This OI we get from out of the 2 oxygen from here. 1 combines with a H2 to form a water. 1 combines with a I minus anion. Step 2. Out of the 2, 1 is used in the step 1 reaction. The second mole of hydrogen peroxide reacts with a OI minus anion created in the step 1 to give us once again one more mole of water molecule. The catalyst what we added comes out as it is and oxygen comes out here. So how do we get the oxygen? we've got a H2O, one O goes as with a hydrogen to form a water. There is one more O left here. This O and this O combines together to go out as, I mean, oxygen gas is formed here and iodide comes out. I hope you understand the reactions involved in it. So what's the molecularity for this again? One mole of hydrogen peroxide reacts with a one mole of, OI minus anion to give us the product. So molecularity is calculated only in terms of the reactant. How many reactants are there? Two reactants are there. Hence here also the molecularity is 2. So molecularity in step 1 is also 2. Molecularity in step 2 also 2. Now we have to come from, put together the step 1 and step 2 to find out the overall reaction. Therefore, overall reaction is equals to, I need to add the step 1 and step 2. Now, if you see here, OI minus is present, OI minus is present. I have cancelled the term. Iodide ion is here, iodide ion is here. I have cancelled the term here. Put together the remaining terms, what will be the answer for us? 1 mole of H2O2 and 1 mole of H2O2 gives me 2 moles of H2O2. No other term is on the left hand side. Come back to the right hand side. 1 mole of water here, 1 mole of water here, we get 2 moles of water molecule. Plus, what is left over? Oxygen is left over. If you refer to the equation, do we get back the same equation? 2 moles of hydrogen peroxide, 2 moles of hydrogen peroxide. 2 moles of water molecule, 2 moles of water molecule. 1 mole of oxygen there, 1 mole of oxygen. So this is how overall reaction is found out. Now one more point I wanted to tell you all. When we calculate the overall reaction concept, you will use it in an electrochemistry chapter, ionic equilibrium chapter. So there we will go in detail. For the timing, all I want you all to remember is, when we calculate the overall reaction step, cancelling should not be done by same side. Now H2O is here, H2O is here, don't go to cancel. Now OI minus anion is on the product side. Here we have taken it on the reactant side. I minus is on the reactant side. Here it's on the product side. So opposite side we have to go to cancel. So OI minus is on the right hand side. Here on the reactant side. Cancel it out. I minus is on the reactant side. I minus on the product side. Cancel out. The remaining terms you put together. So this is the meaning of calculating the number of elementary step. So in inorganic chemistry, most of the reactions we study, the given reaction we balance it. But every reaction has got plenty of elementary steps involved in it like this. In this case, only 2 steps. It can go on to more than 2 steps also. So you understand the concept here. Coming back to, so number of elementary steps involved are step 1 and step 2 regard to decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. Rate determining step. I have taken step 1 to be the rate determining step since it is a slow step. Let me give you a practical example of understanding the rate determining step. Now, in this, the same example if we take here, how many reaction steps are there? 3 reaction steps are there. A to B, B to C, C to D. When we say rate determining step or RDS, rate determining step depends on the slowest step out of the 3. Whichever reaction test step is the slowest one, that step is called as a rate determining step. In these 2 types of elementary step, step 1 is the slowest one. So if you look at it here, hydrogen peroxide reacting with the iodide ion, giving us the formation of a water molecule and OI minus anion takes a long time. So this formation is called as a slow step. Once the OI minus anion is formed, the second mole of hydrogen peroxide quickly reacts with it to give us a water molecule and iodide ion and oxygen. So the first step is the slowest one, second step is the fastest one. So you have to, in the given step, understand or find out which is the slowest step, that is called as a rate determining step. Hence we are writing rate determining step is the step 1. If you consider a cooking rice, If you add in the cold water rice grains, it takes long time for you to get the rice, I mean to get a cooked rice. On the other hand, if you boil water, when you add grains to the boiled water, the rice gets cooked easily. That's an example of slow step. So boiling water takes time. But once the water is boiled, getting the cooked rice is very easy. I mean, it takes place quickly. So boiling water takes place, but getting the cooked rice takes only smaller, a smaller time only. So that's the meaning of rate determining step is the slowest step in the chemical reaction. Therefore, overall reaction is equals to, now overall rate determining step is step 1. Step 1, what's the molecularity? Step 1 is 2. Hence, it's a bimolecular reaction. So how many types of reactants are involved in H2O2 and iodide ion? So H2O2 and I minus. So this is the explanation of understanding the elementary reaction molecularity and how to find out the rate determining step. All you have to remember is the slowest step in the given reaction or involvement of the elementary step, the slowest reaction is taken to be the rate determining step. And for that step, molecularity is 2. Molecular 2 stands for a bimolecular reaction. So this is how we sum up whether it's a unimolecular reaction or a bimolecular reaction or a trimolecular reaction and so on. Moving on to the next concept, order. Now if you look at the reaction I have taken, A plus B gives us the product. Different color rings I have used to make you the concept easier. A, now X stands for coefficient, stoichiometry coefficient. X and Y are stoichiometry coefficient. A and B are reactants giving us the product. Now, in terms of rate, we have no botheration on the product side. Our interest is only on the reactant side. So, how to write the rate law for the given reaction? Rate is equals to proportionality constant into concentration of A into concentration of B. If you see here, some new variable term I have introduced. Here, I have written to be X and Y. Here I am writing M and N. Let's understand the concept in it. It stands for X moles of A and Y moles of B react together to give us the product. Now out of X moles of A, does the 100% of A contribute to the product? No. Only M out of X moles of A, only M part of it only is contributed for the product. Similarly, out of Y moles of B present, only N by Y part of it, meaning out of the Y amount present, only a small amount in it, that's what we call it as a N amount of Y is contributed for the product B. So the amount contributed, present is X moles and a Y moles, but out of the X and Y, only M and N part are contributed for the reaction. So that term is written as a par. So here M in a X moles of A, M part is contributed for the product. Out of Y moles of B, only N part is contributed for the product here. So therefore, order is equals to add up the parts that is given M plus N. Let's take an example. Nitric oxide, 2 moles of nitric oxide reacting with the 1 mole of oxygen to give us the 2 moles of nitrogen dioxide. So writing the rate law is equals to K proportionality constant, concentration of the nitric oxide and a concentration of the oxygen. Remember, some in this case, the order is also 2, the coefficient, okay, imagine 1 to be here. So the order is also 2, the coefficient is also 2 here. Order is also 1, coefficient also 1. But needn't be in all the cases, we will work with some questions. So remember, stoichiometry ratios are different from the order. Order stands for out of the available ratio of the stoichiometry, what part is contributed for the product. In some cases, stoichiometry ratio and the order will remain the same. In some cases, they will be different. That's what I have written here, X, but the order to be M. Why? But the order to be n. In this case, both the stoichiometry ratio and the orders are same. So therefore, order is equals to, calculate the given number, 2 plus 1 is equals to 3. Let's move with the one more question. So the points of distinguish between them. So order of a reaction versus molecularity. Now you understand clearly what's the meaning of order of a reaction and how to understand the molecularity. The same things we put in the points here. Order of a reaction versus molecularity. It's a sum of the parts of the concentration terms present in the rate law. Do you get back what I have told you, children? Sum of the parts present in the rate law concept here. It's a sum of the parts of the concentration terms present in the rate law, you understand. It is the total number of reactants present in the elementary step. You know it very well, how to calculate the number of reactant steps, reactant species involved in the step, and that stands for the molecularity. Done. The second one, its value can be zero, fraction, or an integer. We will have the terms, explanation in the next class there. Its value is always a whole number and can't be zero. So order of the reaction, when you say zero, can be zero order chemicals are there. Fractions, it can be integer. In this case, only it will be a whole number. Zero cannot be the molecularity. Order of molecularity reaction. The third one, it's assigned for the overall reaction. It's assigned for each elementary step of the mechanism. You understand? You might have heard it in the first order reaction, second order reaction, third order reaction. So the order is suitable for the whole reaction. When we say molecularity, it differs from one step to another. In this case, both have got two types of reactants, but it can be different in a different type of questions. So this is the point of distinguish between order of a reaction and a molecularity. Coming back to one more type of distinguish, that is rate of a reaction versus rate constant. Now rate of a reaction, you understand very well from rate law, it's a speed at which the reactants are converted into product. It's a proportionality constant. It is measured as the decrease in the concentration of the reactant. It is equal to the rate of the reaction when the concentration of the reactants are unity, meaning the unity reactant value is equals to 1. It depends on the initial concentration of the reactant. It does not depend on the initial concentration of the reactant. Thank you.